Happy Sunday from National City, where it's actually raining a lot, but I'm knocking on doors.
Nora Vargas walked in the rain in National City, going door to door, asking people to support her campaign. This was during the primary elections last year. She was running for County Board of Supervisors, where there hadn't been a competitive election in 25 years. So when Vargas would show up at her neighbors' doors asking for their vote, it took some trust building.
Folks in the community told me, and mostly in Spanish, right, we're going to give you a chance. And they would call me Norita. My name is Nora, but for some reason, they all, like, you know, all the older ladies would call me Norita. And they're like, you know, Norita, we're going to give you a chance. But we're going to be watching, because politicians come here, they ask us for things, and then they never come back. And I think that's the piece that's really important, right? We have to deliver for our communities.
Latinos in San Diego County had never been elected to the Board of Supervisors, in a county where they make up 34% of the population. But that changed in November's election.
The results are showing Nora Vargas with a healthy lead at 54.5% to Ben Hueso's 45.5%.
Vargas was born in Tijuana. Her mother was a U.S. citizen, her father a Mexican citizen. Going back and forth between two nations is where she believes her political journey began.
I think when I realized that I was in a very unique state, because I was able to cross the border and do all of the, you know, I was able to travel and to learn things, I think that's when it hit me, right? Sort of like, what can I do to make the world better for other people? And I think it was really when I realized, wow, like there is so many opportunities for us to really make a difference in a different way, and politics was an avenue for me to do that.
For Latinas in San Diego, there wasn't a roadmap to political power, so Vargas had to look elsewhere.
To be a Mexicana, a Latina, and then later on, what my friends would say, an honorary Chicana, I count my blessings that I grew up in a family where, you know, going out away to college was actually encouraged, right? That I needed to get an education, that I needed to see the world, that I needed to learn and to make a difference.
Watching her own mother work in local nonprofits and her grandmother run a cross-border business, she told me they were unintentional feminists, a perspective she brought to a Jesuit university in San Francisco.
And having those conversations about what feminism was and what women's rights were, and then me trying to really figure out, well, what does that mean to communities of color, for people who don't have access or opportunities?
Vargas found a place at Planned Parenthood, where she eventually became an executive.
You know, I was a patient at Planned Parenthood. In my household, we didn't talk about sex or sexuality, reproductive health care, right? It wasn't, there was a lot of myths. And I think in our community, sometimes still in the Latino community, there's a lot of sort of taboo around speaking about sexuality.
But her experience at Planned Parenthood and as community college board president pales in comparison to the job ahead of her, dealing with the economic and healthcare fallout of the pandemic. Vargas believes that reaching the community in ways they'll not only understand, but also trust, is the key to ending the pandemic in Latino border communities.
I'm talking and then I can do code switch like that, and I can empiezo a platicar en español y por qué las cosas son importantes. And I think that, like, I did it today, right? We were talking about environmental justice and well, because language shouldn't be a barrier. And then all of a sudden I say to them, muchísimas gracias, gracias por acompañarnos, thank you for being here, you know, we appreciate it, and we're going to work on getting you the information that you need. And I started getting texts from folks saying, like, thank you for doing that. It means the world to them. But, you know, it's who I am. It's my community. And I want them to understand that they're being heard.
For Vargas, activating the next generation of Latina leaders is the most important part of her journey. She's hired several young community organizers to work for her.
My commitment is to try to make sure that the system is really shaken so that the opportunities are there for, you know, women and communities of color to rise and have those opportunities to make those decisions about the future of our communities.
Max Rivlin-Adler, KPBS News.